In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to get from an extremely bad looking sketch to a very good looking expensive logo. Hello and welcome guys, ArmaganVideos here. Today you will see how to go over several iterations of your sketches to make them look better over time, then start to create that logo in Illustrator and finally showcase it in Photoshop. For the showcasing you can find a setup file in the description below, but you will see how we also create it in Photoshop, but I just want to save you some time, so make sure to check the description below.
So here you can see my iPad, and first of all I'm going to show you the apps that I'm mostly using on my iPad. It's Adobe Sketch, Adobe Draw, Sketchbook, my most preferred app, and Procreate, of course everybody knows it. But I'm mostly using Sketchbook as I've mentioned. It's very easy to use, you can change the background color fairly easy. You've got some cool tools right here. These are the primary tools that I'm using to create my logos or making the sketches. And yeah, you can use them as well. And there's a cool tool, a ruler, which lets you draw really straight lines. Of course, that's what a ruler is there for. And yeah, then I'm just creating a new layer, making a straight line, because these charging animal logos are always based on some kind of ground that they are standing on. And yeah, first of all, start with some very basic shapes. Like you can see that looks nothing like the dog that I've showed you. This doesn't as well, but you're slowly getting there. Like after two iterations, you can already kind of see that it looks like a dog or some kind of warthog. It's not what we're going for, but after drawing in a basic shape that you can make out from these sketches, you can see that we're slowly getting there. Like the legs are already there, and then you just start to draw the head and the neck, and it looks really straight and stiff, of course. But yeah, we will finish this up in Illustrator now, and by fixing issue after issue, you're slowly getting a better looking sketch. First of all, I've imported the image from Sketchbook into Illustrator, as you can see it right here. And that is the first trace that I've did of the logo. Here you can see the image from Sketchbook. Just export it there, import it here, set a lock so it doesn't move. And you can also tweak the transparency by double clicking on here and dimming the image. I've just changed it from the transparency tab here. Yeah. As I've mentioned, I've then traced the logo. And how would you do this? Well, first of all, you just create a new layer. I'm going to lock this one real quick, and then you press P to get the pen tool. And some are actually using the pen tool and then going in very little steps to kind of get there. And that's not what I would suggest you when you're going for these type of logos. Just going to disable the foreground color real quick. I'm always using as less anchor points as possible, because this will then force you to tweak the anchor point handles so they're creating perfectly smooth mathematical shapes. So I would just do it like this, and here can then hold on Alt and drag it out here as well, and then you can see you get this nice and cool S kind of shape. And maybe we should change this just like that, and here you can see it looks really perfect. No interruptions in between. Same here, hold on Alt, drag it out. Then here, drag it down, bring it up there again. Here, drag this one down and this one up. And as I've mentioned before, I'm going to show you some websites now that will teach you how to use this pen tool in case you are not aware on how to use it. The first website is The Bezier Game. It's bezier.method.ac, linked in the description below. You have to play some games that will teach you how to use the pen tool. Like here, you just have to draw along these little rectangles, then it teaches you the shortcuts to use the pen tool as well. It's the same shortcuts in Illustrator and Photoshop, so that's really nifty. And here you're going to learn about the handles and how they change the path of your shapes. Boom. And yeah, just play a little bit and you're going to learn all of this and you're good to go to trace your own logos in Illustrator. The next website is colors.co, linked in the description as well. And here, that's a website where you can get matching colors. Just press space and it will give you some cool matching colors. Just like that. There's also a little settings cog right there. You can bring it to monochromatic and then it will choose a specific shade and will variate a little bit off of it to create some monochromatic matching colors, just like that. And I've used this for the logo. Let's jump back to Illustrator. So here we are back again, and let's say you've created or traced your sketch and you're going to finish it up just like that, or you're going to build different shapes and bring them together with the Pathfinder. If you don't see this, go to Window, Pathfinder. And yeah, so how's my workflow? I've got this shape, pressing Shift X to change it to a full shape, like you can just change in between, and then hold down Alt and drag it away to create copies. I've literally just did this, traced the whole dog. That's the first version here. And well, as you can see, I've cut off the head. How would you go about cutting off his head? Sounds really bad, I know, but I have to teach you this. Sorry, Dogo. And well, you got this right here. You can press P, get the pen tool again, make a path like this, and you can see it has a fill kind of, but we want a path, so press Ctrl X, just like that. And now you can see it's a path, so go to Object, Expand, and press OK, so it gets a shape. Now select this, hold down Shift and select this one, and go to the Pathfinder and subtract it. Boom, now it's cut off. You can just easily drag it off and tweak it on how you want it to look like. And I've did this for several versions, like brought it on top of here, and then you've got this anchor point at the bottom, so that was the starting point. Then you just drag it, bring it over here, then you can see it's too fat, so select both and bring it to there. And iteration over iteration, it will get better eventually, and then I've had this, which is still not very cool. But just imagine, like, 5 steps in Sketchbook and 5 steps in Illustrator, and you already get this. And yeah, a lot of people would like this as a logo already, but of course we're not finished here. And a good tip from me is also create several different versions of your logo. Like, start with a new artboard, just create a new document and work in there, because that will refresh your mind and give you maybe some new ideas, or force you to get new ideas. Okay, before we start over and going to the V2 document, I'm going to show you what I've did here real quick. Well, for the text, I've used the Richardson brand font from Sports Font. Just Google it up. There's a lot of sports fonts online nowadays. And I've typed in the text, and then I've used went over to the scale tool and switched it to the shear tool. Hold down Shift and you can drag it to shear the text just like this. Very easy. Then also press S and rotate it a bit in combination with the shear. Whoops. Just like that. And that's it for the text. Very basic. Next up, I've colored the dog to the red and gave it a offset path. And how would you do this? You select this and the dog, bring it down, go to Object, whoops, select both again. Oh, why is it deselecting? I'm too fast. Object, path, offset path, and then you click on preview to see what's going on. You can give it like 14 pixel offset. Hit OK. Now don't select anything. While you're having this selected, go to the Pathfinder and unite it. Then change the color to a black. Oops, not for the outer one, but for the fill. Then right click, arrange, send to back. Make sure that these are on the same layer here, or otherwise send to back will not work. That's it already for this one. Then I've made some shapes here to kind of get rid of the empty holes in our shape there. Send it to the back again, and boom, there we go already. Yeah. Next up, I've tried some different variations, like how thick should I make the background shape, or how thin should it be? Should I align the feet of the dog or the paws to the bottom of our text and stuff like that? That's really up to your logo and your own stuff. So let's head over to the V2 document. Okay, so as I've mentioned, I'm going to show you a very cool trick that many people don't know about. And yep, I think some know about it, of course, but it's really easy to get cool looking shading on your text, or maybe even mascots. And yeah, I'm using Photoshop for this. Not sure if this works in Illustrator as well, but yeah, we're just going to make it in Photoshop real quick. Like, let's say you're having your text just like that. Oops, I have to make it selectable. Okay, that's a bad example. Let's just grab the text from here, where it's a group. Press Ctrl C and head over to Photoshop. We're going to create a new document by pressing Ctrl and N. Create, and press Ctrl V to drag it in, paste it in as a smart object. Hit OK. Now you won't see anything because it's white on white. Click on solid color and make it black. press C and hold down Alt now to increase the size of our artboard here. Now increase the size of this as well. Double click on this layer. And here we've got the layer style, and I'm just going to give it a bevel and emboss, and you can just copy these settings, or I mean, I think these are the standard settings, not sure, and you can tweak a little bit, see how it looks. We want to have an inner bevel with the technique chiseled hard, and here you can tweak the depth actually. There we go, to kind of change the shading. You can also change where the light is coming from. Really cool and nifty. Then you can export this, bring it back into Illustrator, and literally just put the image in here and start to copy the shapes, like go from there to there, then color it gray, just like this. Select these two, press Shift M to get the shape builder tool, hold down Alt to change like the plus to a minus, and then just subtract this, and boom, this is how I've created the shading for the text. Okay, now we are here, and I've told you I'm going to take you on a journey on how I've did the logo, and that was the finished result from the V1 document. But then I've went to a second iteration in Illustrator itself, and I've checked what I didn't like about this, like the crooked neck right here, the legs weren't too thick and sporty kinda. And I've made it just a bit bigger, changed the nose here, rounded up the back, because there's a cool function in Illustrator. You just select an anchor point, then you can see this rounded up circle there, and you can just drag it to round up stuff. Boom. As easy as that, actually. And yeah, I've added, tried a bit of shading here by just changing the shapes there, and that was then the dog that I've liked more, actually. And yeah, as you can see, I've did a lot of iterations, changed a little bit here and there, changed the text again, and well, then I've come up with this. Like, you can see the highlights and the shadows here already. And for this, I've created just two new layers. I've locked my normal dog layer just like here, just lock this, and then I've created a shadow layer and drawn some shadows in, and I've deleted it just like I've showed you with the technique here. So same for the highlights actually, and I've took the colors off from Colors, looked really nice. And then we had this, applied the shading for our text, as I've just showed you with my technique from Photoshop. And yeah, then we ended up here, and that's pretty much it actually. Don't worry if it looks bad in the beginning, like, you know, the sketch that I've showed you in Sketchbook, which looked like a, like some kind of warhawk, or I don't know really, it's, I think it's not even an animal, but you can see how it can come out, and it's really just patience.
One quote that always stuck with me is the following: logo design is a process. What does that mean? Well, you have to go over several iterations to get a good looking logo. You can't just properly start drawing and get a perfect logo. Of course, some actually can achieve this, but only if they have mastered their skills. Like, if you already created logos 100 times or so, you obviously will be faster than someone who's an amateur or just started out creating logos. Don't worry if you're not a professional or a professional drawer or something like this. It just takes more time, but you will eventually get there and get a good looking logo that will look great in your portfolio, or which you can sell for a good amount of money. So just keep practicing.
So I've showed you how to sketch something, what to have in mind when designing, like not using a lot of anchor points. So all you need to do now is select this logo, bring it over to Photoshop. We're going to create a new document real quick, Command and N. I'm going to make it 3333 pixels wide and 2500 pixels wide with a resolution of 72 ppi. Click Create. Then I'm going to delete this. Click on solid color to give it a background color, and I'm just going to steal the color from here real quick. There we go. Now let's bring in our logo. Oop, I somehow didn't copy it. Maybe I should select everything, Control C multiple times, Control V, smart object, hold down Alt to scale it up from the center. There it is, maybe a little bit smaller. Next up, press Ctrl J, select the lower one and scale this one up. Ctrl J duplicates the layer. So that's going to be for the background, and I'm going to bring down the opacity, so just very slightly in the background. Then give it a mask, just like that. Go to the gradient tool and drag this out. And if it drags it out, or if it creates the gradient in a reversed way, you can just tick reverse and it will do this for you. But for me, it's working already. So I want to have it slightly at the edges here, too much. Okay, that will be fine. Let's select this object, go to filter. Oops, we have to convert to smart object. Then rasterize, filter, blur gallery, field blur to kind of blur it out in a cool way. Give it like 15 pixels blurriness, and there it goes, just like that. Next up, we're going to create the cool lightning setup here that we've had. So click on this little icon, go to gradient, and we're going to make it white. Very important, change both of these. Oops, then drag this pop-up down, change it to radial, and just drag it to the top right there, and then scale it up. Boom. Then change the blending mode from normal to like pin light or something like that. It's really just trial and error. And then drag this fill down a little bit. I think like, yeah, maybe 37 or so will look cool. Boom. Of course, you don't have to create this in Photoshop. You can find this setup in the description below, so make sure to check it out. I'm just going to show you this in case you're not that skilled in Photoshop and want to learn this part as well. Or maybe you want to create completely different looking setups and not use my setup file, so I'm showing you this. Okay, next up, we're going to create another gradient. This time it's going to be black. Okay, perfect. Radial. Bring it to the top again, but this time check reverse and scale it up a lot more. You can already see that looks really, really nice. Now change the blending mode to like, where do we have it? Yeah, pin light looks, hard mix looks very good actually. Let's choose linear burn and bring down the fill a little bit. I think this is fine. You can also readjust it a little bit, just like that. And the last path, that's up to you part, I mean, is adding the text and the typography, your own logo, a little bit of text. And you can also darken up the whole logo a bit by creating a black layer and then changing the blending mode to like linear burn again and make it a little bit darker. Or you can add actually texture and put it on linear burn and change the fill. Yeah, that's it for this one. And the last part that is missing is actually taking your logo, go to filter, blur gallery, iris blur or tilt shift. You can actually try it out and then just give it a little bit of blur on the edges. Maybe bring it to like 20. Boom, there we go. Now you can add some noise, some textures, your text, and you're good to go. That's it for the showcasing in Photoshop. Now we've got everything come full circle. I've showed you the sketching, the different iterations, the techniques for the pen tool, the shading in Photoshop, then the presentation in Photoshop, the colors, and you've got every single skill set to create a cool looking logo just by practicing it and creating several different iterations of your logo. I know you can't hear the word iteration anymore, but it really is what makes a good looking logo or skill. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Until the next time. Armagan videos.
If you enjoy these videos, it would be really cool if you could leave a comment, like, and subscribe. But that decision is completely up to you, of course.